Welcome back to another episode of Georgia Forages, the digital series. My name is Dr. Lisa Baxter, and I'm your University of Georgia State Forage Extension Specialist. Today, we're going to talk about managing the fall armyworm. Fall armyworms are by far the most important caterpillar pest in our Georgia pastures and hay fields. They can quickly decimate an entire field of Bermuda grass, fescue, and many other forage crops that we grow in our state. Before we can control an insect, we need to know more about its biology. The fall armyworms do not overwinter in Georgia, even in the southernmost parts of our state. The moths actually overwinter in Florida and will move north each year on weather fronts, reinfesting our state from south to north. This process can take several generations, which is why damage usually does not appear until late summer or even early fall in the northern parts of our state. An armyworm moth can lay eggs in batches of 50 to several hundred eggs, allowing the population to grow quite rapidly. Each female moth can lay up to 2,000 eggs in her lifetime. These eggs will hatch into small 1/8-inch light green caterpillars, usually within 2 to 4 days. The larvae will grow and begin turning brown until it reaches the full 1.5-inch size in 2 to 3 weeks, depending on our weather conditions. The young fall armyworms tend to stay down in the canopy during the day. Their feeding is less damaging and harder to see. Most producers will identify armyworms at the fully grown larval stage. They can be up to 1.5 inches long and are light green to nearly black, with white and dark stripes that stretch horizontally along the body. One of their most distinct characteristics is the inverted Y shape on the head of the worm. The large armyworms are fairly easy to find because of their size. They're typically most active in the early morning or late afternoon when temperatures are cooler, but have been known to feed throughout the entire day. Careful scouting is the best way to prevent economic losses. An insect sweep net can help you identify low populations of the fall armyworm before significant feeding damage occurs. Some birds, such as cattle egrets, may serve as an indicator of armyworm activity, but it's not always guaranteed, especially throughout the coastal plains where the birds are nearly always present. Unfortunately, many armyworms will go unnoticed until the feeding damage begins to occur. The damage can appear differently depending on the forage type and condition. Armyworms prefer high-quality, well-maintained forage and will select those high-quality pastures and hayfields first. Most damage begins as ragged leaves or areas with stripped stems. In hayfields and pastures with tall growth, the damage can be quite devastating, to which nearly all of the tender green vegetation will be removed in severe cases. Damage may appear as thinned out grass or brown spots in overgrazed pastures, which is often misdiagnosed as drought damage. Often after severe armyworm infestation, the only vegetation left in the field will be tough stems. Treatment thresholds are usually set at 3 armyworm larvae per square foot, but weather and forage demands may dictate a more conservative threshold. Harvesting a hay crop may be the best option for armyworm control if the hay is close to cutting already. If insecticides are required, be sure to follow all label instructions. Our insecticides are labeled for specific life stages of the fall armyworm. But in general, small caterpillars will be easier to control than the larger worms. There are several insecticides available, but we need to pay close attention to the grazing and haying restrictions related to these products. You may want to consider a residual control option as well. Products vary in their length of residual control and application cost, so you will need to determine the potential returns on this investment for your operation. If you need more specific insecticide recommendations, please consult the Georgia Pest Management Handbook and your local county extension agent.